dapat sinusunda natin maigi yung tatakbo. And that's why sometimes, para lang matuto ang tao, namimilito ko. Last time I ran, just to check whether people are thinking. And that's why you remember I told Mr. Aquino, Mr. Aquino, you cannot inherit the presidency. You have to earn it. Mr. Villar, you cannot buy the presidency. You have to earn it. Mr. Estrada, you cannot act your way to the presidency. You have to earn it. And we're still having that spectacle. We have people being elected in the Senate that are just sitting around. Tataas lang ang boto. Saan ba tayo buboto? Dito tayo. Ayun, tataas ang kamay. I'm not criticizing some of my friends, their friends, but I think we owe it, the public, anybody, including you. If you think you can do something about it, you should aim to run for public office because there's a paucity of principled, value-based leaders who know what they're doing. And it is also the duty of every citizen to see to it that he doesn't vote on whim, caprice, or winability. Nobody knows who's going to win. Something can happen. And what he needs to do is say, I will pick the best. And I think that should be a slogan. We must pick the best and the right candidate to make sure that we have a great, great country.
Okay. Now, Senator, so with Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte running, possibly running, would you consider that in a way inheriting the presidency or its marks of political dynasty as well?
Well, both. She can run.
Even if it's an election process, it's a democracy, people will decide.
Yes, people we think decide, but you know, guns, guns and gold decide. They're influential. At the same time, people will always think, anak ng presidente, hindi papatalo ng presidente. And there's a lot of the flop. Analysis is important these days. Ang daming paputok ng malaki niya, tatakbo akong vice president. Sabi ni Juan, now, sabihin niya, o si Martin Romualdez. Tapos, o si Pacquiao, hindi ka pwede. Tatanggalin na kami na si Pacquiao. Awawa naman si Pacquiao. You know, and so all this flop, all these noises, you must learn to sift from the smoke and be able to see through what is happening. There is mind management that has always happened in this country from the time of the Spanish, and we have learned to do it to our own countrymen. Na, ikaw Indio ka, simbergwensa ka, hanggang dyan ka lang sa baba, hindi ka pwede sa taas. You cannot be trusted. Tamad ka. All these are, you know, colonial hangover na dapat matigil na. Ang dapat na sabihin, di ba nakikita natin yung spectacle in any country? Somebody is ahead in the polls and he refuses to debate. Do you think that the American press, they will be allowed to do that? They'll be drummed out of the race, right? Takot ka. You don't know anything, di ba?
Now, in the United States, you have to join the debate. But I'm. It's interesting you said that because in the Philippines, especially now, with ABS-CBN shut down, what are you seeing, Senator, as the change this coming elections?
Well, I think to a certain extent it would be less expensive because of the lack of advertising. First, people have no money. But on the other hand, people with money, yung mga billionaire yan, they can buy easily. Mas madaling bumili dahil walang pera yung tao. That's danger. Dapat ngayon pa lang sinasabi na natin sa tao. Yan.
Pero, you mean buy directly into locally?
It's happening. We all know that. The drug pushers, the contractors who turn politicians, they have a lot of money na bibili. I don't believe our democracy is really working. It's a nice ideal state. But in reality, we do not allow the people to discern. Dapat tinuturuan natin ang tao mamili. It is the duty of every citizen to vote wisely. Akala natin, vote na lang. Akala natin kahit na sino pwede. Imagine, sinasabi nga ng iba, walang qualification sa presidente. Basta marunong ko lang mag-read the rights. Sige na, pwede na. Or senator. And yet, we know what the solution is. We skirt around it, but we don't do anything about it. To my mind, you should put everybody to the ringer, to the test. For example, in the next few years, you could have a war in Asia. The Chinese could attack Taiwan anytime. You know, that's happened in the Kremlin, in Russia. They took over Crimea. Mm-hmm. You know, and
You need a president, what you're saying, who is capable. Yes, I wanted to ask you just very quickly, what are the conditions for you to decide? Clearly, it will be a life-altering decision, but what are your personal conditions for you to decide to run for the presidency, or you decide again to run for the Senate? I mean, with you, it's not just the surveys. There's something more. What is it?
I don't think of myself as a, my decision would be a life-changing thing for me. I run for the people. I run.
Okay. So what are you looking for? What parameters are you looking for, watching out for?
I'd like to have peace in the household. I like my wife to be satisfied that I'm running. I like my family to be satisfied that I'm running, that I can contribute. And all of them practically know you've done so much already, time to stop.
Okay.
I don't believe that. But I do believe this. If one has something to offer and you don't join the fray, you're a coward. You cannot allow all these doubts. We are living in a country that shoots you with doubt. You know, Shakespeare says, and I quote this all the time, our doubts are traitors and make us fear to do the good we ought to win by fearing to attempt.
And that's a good one.
Yeah.
Okay, so coming from this reasoning, is it fair to say you are 90% maybe you might run for the presidency?
I can even go beyond that. If you
95.
I can even go beyond that. If you ask me to take over the presidency, I will do it without even a breath.
To take over, but I'm saying to run in 2022. Where are you? Where are you right now? Are you?
I am losing. I called up Zamboanga yesterday. I called up my friends in Batangas. They came over to the office. I am listening to our people. And they say, to a man, they say, we have to change the situation. Situation has gotten bad to worse. Look at your Facebook. Everybody's saying, you need a president that we can all be proud of, that we can negotiate with other countries in a dignified manner, God-fearing, not, you know, and knowing that you cannot kill the people. You cannot, you know, look at all the issues being waged against us. I've said this before, and I hope the president forgives you for doing this. But if he doesn't, then that's the way it is. You make your bed, you sleep in it, you know. For example, right now there is this pati nga ako sinama pa doon.
Senator, how would a Sara Duterte presidency possibly affect the Philippines? Would it be good for the country? How would that be for you?
It might be good, but I think, you know, I could have run when I was doing Subic Bay. That was the best time to run. Everybody was telling me you should have run that time. Mm. That's Monday morning quarterbacking. You know, I don't regret not having run during those times, because in the times that I've come in, I have seen many challenges, disasters, other challenges, and I feel I am over-prepared.
So you're over-prepared. So just give me an idea. What are the chances of you running? I mean, is it 90%, 80%? What is it?
I am available.
Yes, that's different from you actually running.
And it's a question of a strategy you want to announce. It's always politics.
Okay. So you are right.
Destiny. You make destiny.
If you run, will you have a vice presidential candidate?
Most definitely. There are people who are trying to negotiate certain things right now among my group and seeing whether that would be a better chance for us if we have somebody who will run that is acceptable to the public. I think in terms of whoever my vice president will be, like last time, I had Bayani Fernando. Why? We're both good leaders. We're both no nonsense. We are both implementers. If I win, then he succeeds me. He can continue. It takes 20 years of continuous good leadership to be able to make sure that the country progresses. Singapore did it in 20 years. Japan, after the major restoration, did it in about 30 years. After the war, Japan did it in 20 years after they were bombed. It takes a while of continuous, sustainable, good leadership. And to my mind, we don't have that.
But 20 years of a bad leader is way too long, too.
Oh, don't we know it? Don't we know it? And we had President Marcos, who was good, and then eventually he turned sour. Because kailangan ang tao nakikialam. Kailangan di tayo basta naniniwala sa propaganda. You must always put the president, answer questions straightforward, hindi yung umiiwas. You know, I remember Reagan, umiiwas.
My last question is, in case if you decide otherwise, will you come out in the open and support a particular candidate? Will you do that?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Okay. I will support whoever will be best for our country, not on the basis of he's my friend. He's good looking. He's popular. He will help me because he's very popular. I will decide, and I will be adding to the delinquency of our people if I just say, oh, ito mananalo, ito kunin natin ito kahit na walang prinsipyo.
Mm-hmm. All right. Okay. On that note, so Senator Richard Gordon, thank you so much for joining me today. But so it seems that we will be waiting for this big day when you will make an announcement. It looks like you will.
I'm praying on it.
Okay, all right. I'm praying on it. All right, thank you
one
so much.
Lady. You're one top lady. You ask very
so you're praying on it. Okay. All right. Thank you so much, Senator Richard Gordon, for joining me today. Thank you.